Good day to you from ChemHelp ASAP. Let's discuss how drugs and metabolites ultimately get out of an organism through excretion pathways. By the end of this video, students will be able to describe renal excretion, describe biliary excretion, and put hepatic, renal, and biliary elimination in context for oral drugs and their metabolites. In discussions of oral drugs, hepatic metabolism is the main form of clearance. Why? To better understand, let's look at this image of a nephron from the kidney. Blood, which contains a circulating drug, enters the nephron, and dissolved small molecule drugs transfer into Bowman's capsule. At this point, oral drugs, which normally have high membrane permeability, will undergo tubular reabsorption and re-enter systemic circulation. Therefore, renal clearance for oral drugs is typically low, even negligibly low. Therefore, hepatic clearance is often the main driver for total clearance. If a drug is renally cleared, it will appear unchanged, unmetabolized in the urine. Evidence for renal clearance is first apparent during preclinical in vivo PK studies, during which unchanged drug is detected in an animal's urine. Note that while the high membrane permeability of oral drugs minimizes renal excretion, drug metabolites, which are normally much less permeable because of conjugation with polar groups, do undergo renal excretion. Another excretion pathway is biliary excretion, excretion in the bile, which is formed in the liver. As with renal excretion, the properties of oral drugs do not lend themselves to biliary excretion. Polar drug metabolites, especially conjugation metabolites, phase II metabolites, are more prone to being excreted in the bile from the liver. The metabolites ultimately re-enter the GI tract in the small intestine and will be excreted in the feces. This overall process is called biliary excretion. Biliary excretion is normally less important for the parent oral drug, but may be very relevant for metabolites of a drug. The observation of unchanged, unmetabolized drug in the feces may indicate that the drug is incompletely absorbed and has simply passed through the patient. To wrap this up, oral drugs are generally somewhat nonpolar and membrane permeable. Their primary mode of clearance is hepatic metabolism. Once a drug undergoes metabolism and forms a metabolite, the metabolite is typically more polar. This trend is especially true for phase II metabolites, in which polar groups like a sulfate or glutathione are added to a molecule. The increased polarity of metabolites reduces membrane permeability and makes the metabolites more prone to renal and biliary excretion. This overall trend is why, in general, hepatic clearance is the main driver when considering elimination of oral drugs. Other elimination pathways, such as renal and biliary excretion, are relevant to metabolites of oral drugs, but not as much for the parent drug.
We have described both renal and biliary excretion. We've also explained why hepatic clearance tends to be the most important elimination pathway for oral drugs, but renal and biliary elimination more affect metabolites.
That concludes our quick summary of biliary and renal excretion, which are particularly important for metabolite excretion. If you have any questions, please ask them in the comments section below the video. Take care.